Hi everyone, welcome back. In this tutorial, I will show you how to customize the quick popups in Blazor Scheduler component. The quick info popups are the ones that gets opened when a cell or appointment is clicked on the cell or event. On clicking a cell, you can simply provide a subject and save it. Also, while clicking on an event, a popup will be displayed where you can get the overview of the event information. You can also edit or delete those events through the options available in it. First, I open the existing Blazor WebAssembly app, where I have added the Blazor Scheduler component with T-value property and bound the appointment data model class to it. I have bound this event to the data source property. If you want to see how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add a scheduler component to it, check out the video linked in the above YouTube card. You can also find this example by following the link in the provided description below. Let's run the example application. Look at the scheduler component, it renders with provided appointment. When I click on a cell, the built-in quick info popup open. I can simply provide the subject and save it. Similarly, when you click on an appointment, you can view its appointment details. By default, these popups are displayed over the cells and appointments of scheduler. If you need to disable this action, set false to show quick info property. Now, let's see how to customize the quick popup on a cell in the Blazor Scheduler component. To get started, I bound resources to the appointments in the scheduler. Within this tag, I have bound this room's data model class to T-item property. And assign resource data list to the data source property. And configure various properties such as T-value, field, title, name, and so on to define the resource. If you want to know more information about scheduler resources, check the video link provided description below. Next, I use the Schedule Quick Info Templates option to customize the look and feel of the quick pop-up window. I can customize the header, content, and footer with templates. Now, I create a method called getEventDetails, which will take an appointment data parameter. Inside this method, I set the start time and end time of the event. After that, I define the Schedule Quick Info Templates tag and set the template type property to cell. Within the tag, I add the header template. The header included a title add appointment. I have added three division tags with appropriate class and a duration text obtained from the getEventDetails function, which takes appointment data as the context. I applied inline CSS to style the header, aligning the content to the center and setting the color. Next, I define the content template, which customizes the content part of the quick pop-up. Inside this template, I will be showcasing the Syncfusion dropdowns and text box components. To begin, I add the necessary namespaces for the dropdowns and inputs component. Following that, I declare three component references, dropdown list, and text box components. Within the scheduler, now I update the content template. It includes three content areas. The first content area contains a Syncfusion text box component and added reference for the text box using ref property. It displays the value of the subject obtained from the appointment data context and has the placeholder title. The second content area contains a Syncfusion dropdown list component and added reference from the dropdown list using ref property. It is bound to the data source as resource data and displays a list of options. The selected value is of type int, and the item type is rooms data. The field settings define the display text as name and the value as ID. The third content area contains another text box component, referenced as description reference. It displays the value of the description obtained from the appointment data context and has the placeholder notes. Last is the footer template, which customizes the footer part of the quick popup. Before implementation, first I create a scheduler component reference named as schedule reference. After that, I create the method named on more details click, which takes mouse event args and appointment data as parameters. It is triggered when the more details button is clicked. I close the quick info popup by calling the close quick info popup async method using the schedule reference object. Then I create a new appointment data object named event data with the following properties, such as ID, subject, start time, end time, location, and so on. Then I open the editor asynchronously by calling the open editor async method using the schedule reference object, passing the argument as event data, and add from the current action class. Finally, I will update the footer template inside the quick info popup. I will define the Syncfusion button components for showcase the more details and add button. Now, I'm adding the namespace to the button component. The first button has the content more details and triggers the on more details click event handler when clicked. The event handler is defined inline using appointment data as its context. Next, I'll be introducing another button that allows us to add more events to the scheduler. To begin, I create the onAdd method. It creates a new appointment data object, named cloneData by cloning the properties of the data object and assigning them to the corresponding properties of the cloneData object. The ID property is set to a random value generated by the new random. The subject, description, room ID, and so on, these all the properties are copied from the data object. Then I call the addEventAsync method using the schedule reference object, passing the clone data object as a parameter. This method seems to add the clone data appointment to the schedule. Then, I add the second button. It has the content add and is set as the primary button using the primary style is added to button. It triggers the onAdd event handler when clicked. The event handler is also defined inline using the context of appointment data. I need to make sure I added the reference property set to the schedule reference in scheduler's tag. Finally, I add CSS styles to the header, content, and footer templates. I set the CSS class property to QuickInfo to add custom styles to the scheduler's QuickInfo popup. Now, let's look at the output page. When I single-click on the cell, you can see the title and duration in the header template and the content text boxes and dropdowns in the content template. More details and add buttons are displayed in the footer. When I click more details, it displays all the new event details. Next, let's see how to customize quick popups on events in the Blazor Scheduler component. First, I remove the onAdd method and any corresponding content details, as they are not needed for this. Then, I update the onMoreDetails method to remove the schedule reference in the subject, description, and room ID. Now, I remove the declared component references as they are not needed for this. Then I update the additional appointment for a clear understanding in quick popup event. After that, the schedule quick info templates component now has the template type set to event, indicating that the customization is for event-related quick popups. In the header template, I change the title to appointment details instead of add appointment to display event details. Moving on to the content template, I updated with a C# code block used to define the content of the event quick popup. The appointment data is set to the local variable data. Inside the event content container, there are three sections: subject, type, and notes. The subject section displays the label subject followed by the value of subject in data. The type section checks if the room ID in data is not zero. Then, it fetches the associated resource item from resource data using workquery and displays its name property. Otherwise, an empty string is displayed. The notes section displays the label notes followed by the value of description in data. Finally, I update the CSS style and header template based on the condition. See here, when I click on the event, you can see the title and duration in the header template and the subject, type, and notes for event details in the content template. The More Details button is in the footer template. When I click it, it displays the option to edit the details for an event. In this video, I covered how to customize the quick popups for cells and events in the Blazor Scheduler component. For more information on Scheduler's features, be sure to check out the documentation link provided in the video description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.